You don't even necessarily need to make a model. The exact same result. The technology itself has changed tremendously. Hi everyone, and welcome back to Xgate Dental. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh, and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases. Don't forget to subscribe and follow us to stay up to date. Let's get started. Today we are going to be covering the CAD CAM topics. The evolution of CAD CAM started when we were introduced to scanners, not only intraoral scanners, but desktop scanners as well. It gives us a lot of options to approach from different perspectives, and we are able to gain a ton of information. For each case that we scan, we are able to get all of the relevant information, such as the position of each tooth. Before the era of the CAD CAM technology, when we had to make a crown and we wanted to duplicate that crown, it would literally never be the exact same. But now, thanks to this new technology, we have all of the information that we can use as we please and duplicate without any issues, making any necessary adjustments, as well as have all of the information saved for the future. Today, we will be looking at different cases, and we will be going over the different approaches that we are able to use thanks to the CAD CAM technology, the invention of the scanner, and the milling machine. So let's begin. There are a few factors that have changed the way we work, one of them being the new wave of 3D printers. So let's say 10 to 15 years ago, if we had a scanner and a machine, you weren't able to make a model. Now, you can do everything digitally from start to finish. You can scan with the intraoral scanner, no need for traditional impressions. You have all the information that you'll need digitally on the computer in front of you. You don't even necessarily need to make a model because you can make the bridge on the impression that you've already taken before. So the model is a digital one just to see if it fits, and then everything else is fine, and then you don't have any aesthetic issues. This also takes away the need for the patient to come in each time. Today, we will show you different cases and different approaches on how to use the CAD CAM and different advantages. This is the first case. You can see here that we have a tooth, no implant, and we want to make a crown. Now, to make a perfectly symmetrical crown of tooth 11 with 21, it's very hard for manual manufacturing. In this case, what we did is we scanned, we mirrored the tooth, and then we made a crown. However, it's not the first crown that we made. We had different versions made up. In every version, we made some adjustments with the color and things like that. And in the end, even if she'll break this crown, we already have the information saved. We don't need to do anything again. We can just take the exact copy of the crown, mill it again, color it again, and we have the same results. If we were to do it before with the traditional method, first of all, you can't make an exact copy. Every time you want to add something or remove something, you're losing the information of what was there previously. So if something doesn't feel right, you don't know what was there before. Let's say we are making a PFM, for example, and you want to add ceramics. You need to go to the technician, give him the crown, you need to add ceramics, burn the crown, and then give it back to the patient. So in this case, you have the first crown. You can make a new one, and then you can compare between the crowns in the same appointment. You can show her both crowns, and in the end, you'll get the exact same result with great color and everything you need. And best of all, you have a copy of the crown. If something happens to the crown, you just mill it again and make it again. The second thing we want to show you is that with all of the information, you can take, for example, an old denture, and in the lab on the same day, make new teeth. You can save the model of the teeth. You can add, you can adjust, you can do whatever you want. And today, with the printers, it's starting to be more and more popular. Because previously, when you made dentures, you needed to cure the denture. You needed to position all the teeth, you needed to have models, you needed to have all the information in the articulator. And now, dentures are starting to be an easy process. Today, you can print the dentures, you can mill the teeth, you can just glue them one to another, and you have the final denture. In this case, the denture we did are metal-based, so we took off the old teeth and replaced them with new ones. Everything was done in one day. Let's take a step back for a second. There's definitely a learning curve with the intraoral scanner. You need to understand that the feel of the intraoral scanner isn't the same as the traditional impressions. However, when a doctor gets a new intraoral scanner and for 20 years he took traditional impressions, it's definitely going to be a new feel and kind of different at first. He needs to get used to the intraoral scanner. But from what we know, any doctor that got used to the intraoral scanner never even looked back. You can take 99% of your impressions with an intraoral scanner. You have everything you need, and it's so much more precise and so much better than traditional impressions. On the other hand, you do have some sort of inaccuracies with the intraoral scanner. If you take one job with traditional methods, you'll have more accurate results. However, all the intra-occlusion relations, any inaccuracies in the impression, you won't know until you have the end results and until you check the bridge and see that it doesn't fit. But with the intraoral scanner, you know from the beginning that you have a problem and you can fix the problem right away because you have everything on the screen. If you make a tooth preparation, for example, with the impression, you don't always know that the tooth wasn't prepared as best as it could be. But with the intraoral scanner, you can see the angles of each tooth. You can see if you need to adjust something, to fix something, to correct something before you send it for a crown manufacturing or a crown design. This allows you to have so much more information on the screen right next to your chair. The advancement of the scanner was extremely fast. Even if you look back like 3 years ago, the program, the scanners, the technology itself has changed tremendously. Every year the programs are updated as well as the technology. Everything changes very fast and you have much better results in such a short time. If you look at traditional impressions, the impressions today are exactly the same as they were 10 years ago and 20 years ago. The materials changed a bit, but there's no breakthrough with the materials or with the technology. Let's take a look at the next case. First of all, we took the denture and we scanned it. This denture was scanned with a desktop scanner. When we scan the denture, we know how the teeth are now because you can see that the teeth moved a little bit. We took off the teeth, we'll adjust the metal carcass and scan this as well. We position them one on top of another. So what you can see is you have a denture base, you have the old denture. Now on top of the denture base, you want to build new teeth. You want the teeth to be a little bit higher than the older teeth. You can design everything in the design programs, which is unbelievable. This one was designed with CAD. You can see that the new teeth, they've been designed for the new height because the older ones were worn off. You can see the occlusion because when we took the impressions in occlusion. We raised the occlusion a little bit to compensate for the new teeth, and you can make the exact teeth that you'll need. Now, if this case was made with plastic teeth, that was placed manually. You couldn't receive the same occlusion as we did with the CAD CAM because these teeth will be milled and later on will be cured on the denture base. So you will have exact occlusion. You don't need to change anything. The teeth are made for this case. The process itself was all done in one day. We took the impressions and by the end of the day, the patient got this dentures back. The scanning, the modeling, the design was made in about 3 to 4 hours. Then the milling of the teeth was about 2 hours on top of that. And curing the teeth took also about 2 to 3 hours. So then what's left is polishing, a few adjustments, and you have the teeth by the evening. Let's say we didn't use the CAD CAM for this procedure. The process would have taken so much longer because we would have needed to do it all manually. The end results won't be as accurate. You need to adjust yourself to the new technology. This is why CAD CAM in this case, for example, is great because you take the library teeth that you want. You know that all the teeth will be perfect. You mill all the teeth together. You won't have breakage. You won't have chipping. You won't have anything go wrong with these teeth. Then you cure just the teeth to a plastic base and you have great results. This is a win-win for both patients and doctor. Both the patients and doctor are able to do the whole process in a single day. Some doctors aren't even aware that they can do all this in such a short time because they aren't aware of this new technology. It ultimately saves a lot of chair time, and in the end, chair time is what costs money. Doctors are able to take more patients in the same day. What you see that we did here, we had the teeth milled with the new design of the teeth. The teeth perfectly match the base of the denture, so you just place the teeth and you know that they're in a great position. You just need to add a little bit of wax for the curing and then you'll be done later. And in the end, what you'll get is a perfectly like new denture with the same metal base with new teeth, all done in one day. Patients see advertisement all over that they're able to get new teeth in just one day. Not all of the treatments can or should be done in a single day. However, it is possible thanks to all of this new technology. Let's say implantations or something like that you shouldn't do in one day. There are definitely benefits in taking your time with those procedures, but if you can do it as fast as you want, patients want it. They're looking for something that will take the least amount of time and pay as little as possible for it. Thank you everyone that joined to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. Thank you and see you next time.